Mikey Pipes and Peter Pan. Happy Thursday. Thursday, December 18th. Right? 16th. And tomorrow's Friday. Can't wait.
Not waiting.
We are on the North Shore of Long Island, Gold Coast. We're gonna go fix a Taj Mahal. I love me Taj Mahals. They're just beautiful, beautiful palaces. Let me show you. You see? People got walls protecting their Taj Mahals. Let's go find the run we're going to. All right. Let me announce I'm here. Me, Mikey Pipes. Hi, it's Mike from the Pipe Doctor. Thank you. That is nice. I gotta get me walls and gates like this for my little mini Taj Mahal. All right, I don't want to show too much, but the guy's got like his own little lake.
Good morning. Should I close the garage? Okay.
I'm sure you're going to be going back and forth.
Probably.
Hi.
How are you? Excellent. So what's wrong, though? I know you have the OC error.
So we have the OA error, and then we have the radiant in our bathroom's been cold, so I went down there, and that valve, I think, is
shot.
Is shot.
Okay. All right.
Thank you. Come on.
Everything's been good?
Yeah, everything's good.
Excellent.
I think you guys are going to figure out your own way at this point. We'll just give you a key.
How about we take one of the cars instead?
No problem.
Just for, as a loaner. Still that temperature.
Yeah, I don't know. If you want to put a fan, let's talk about it.
So outdoor air sensor error.
Yeah.
Okay. And you said master bathroom radiant zone.
Bath, and you know, I don't know if it's calling for heat now, but I just went.
Now that I see you in person, what's the deal with these thermostats
that's
like
me.
That? Why?
Because that's my stupid shit doing it. That I'm, you know, because I couldn't find anybody to do it, so I did it myself.
Okay, it works.
You want to clean it up? Be my guest.
Why waste the money if you don't have to?
You know, that's all on me.
Okay. It was curiosity killed the cat.
It was my mistake in the beginning when we built the house that we didn't home run the thermostats. And then it's my mistake because I couldn't find anybody to do the job. And are you recording me?
Yeah.
Okay, because I was going to tell you who did the work, and he did a fantastic job.
I love the piping.
He did a
beautiful job.
But we had a hole falling out. And
really?
He screwed me in the end.
That sucks.
Yeah.
Because realistically, this is... It's pretty impressive. And you can see you got what you paid for here.
Amazing job.
Yeah. All right, which one is the radiant?
That.
209. Oh, 207. Master.
Yeah. Just kind of try and flick it, and you'll see it just...
Oh, where's the...
It's not moving.
Oh, it's shot. Okay, so we need a new zone valve. All right. Is this your doing?
Nope, I didn't touch anything.
How it's stripped there?
I didn't touch it.
Okay. All right. And the OA era. Do you know where the outdoor air sensor is?
I couldn't even begin to tell you.
Because it won't really affect the operation, it's just the outdoor air sensor error. But we'll look outside and see if we can find it.
I'm trying to see if we have a wire somewhere. If you want to do that fan, let's do that fan.
The fan in a can?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then of course we need to do the ACs at some point.
I got to find out where these go outside.
See, I see air coming in.
Yeah.
I can actually see it.
Yeah.
So there's two outlets.
Yeah, I can see that. I see light.
Yeah, this one's easy. This one, there's a big white panel on the side of the house. And I think that one also. Okay.
I didn't notice this last time I was here. He's got the 911 up there. Beautiful. And the white Ferrari.
That's a Ferrari, too.
All right, first thing we're going to do is try to find the outdoor air sensor. And good luck to me. But look what we have here.
Hi. You guys know Steve? They got big.
All right.
Thank goodness they're really like a point.
Yeah, it is like a point.
Good luck to me trying to find this outdoor air sensor era in this, I don't know, mansion. It's like a castle. But where there's a will, there's a way. And we're not going to let this deter us from succeeding here. Let's go.
All right. This is going to be a very informative and instructional video. There's our zone valve, right? If you guys remember, we replaced this one a few months ago. It took me about almost an hour, over an hour, to find out what was causing relays to spaz out like it was having a seizure. But we found it. There's Peter Pan, with two Buderuses. We'll find the outdoor sensor. All right, Honeywell zone valves, very common here in New York. This model has been around forever, but there's a screw here and there's a screw there, right? I take out those two screws, I can pull the whole body off, sorry, the whole head off the body, right? If I have more than two screws, I gotta replace the whole assembly. Okay. All right, so I removed the two screws off the oldest valve. I took the new valve, mounted it with those same two screws. And before we even go any further wiring, we're gonna make sure that the components inside are working. So right now it's in the manual open position. It comes shipped that way. We're gonna just pump that out and we're gonna make sure that that moves the way it should, like it just did. And now we're gonna try to, perfect. See? So we're good. What's really weird is that I can buy just this head for a dollar less than the whole body, than everything.
Really?
Yeah, really. Supplyhouse.com, real people, real service. All right. Now, let's take a step down. You can see on this Wago, on this zone valve named Mosaic Bath.
And we're not
talking about JetBlue's reward program, loyalty program. The Mosaic, right? It's a Mosaic bathroom.
Here's what I found.
Shut up, Siri. All right, and then I have them all connected to here with my Wagos. So we're going to do the same thing with that. I separated it from there already. And we're going to try to get in there and make it nice and pretty. All right, let me go over the wiring real quick with you. This is a red and that red, right? Is it those two or is it that? No, it's these two. These two are end switches, right? And all these red wires connect to one wire. So one set, there's two red wires coming from each zone valve, okay? So every one of each red wire from each zone valve is connected to one wire, which then goes to TT or XX, right? That's the end switch.
Okay.
And the other red wire, same thing. Mm-hmm. And inside, deep in here, all those red wires are together. And I didn't want to mess with that. I could have, you know, I don't have a 16-thing Wago, a 16-conductor Wago. So I just cut the reds, right, instead of digging in there and risk touching or breaking something and then spending all day here figuring out low-voltage wiring, what broke, what didn't, right? So I got my two reds. Now, with the yellows, right, which is 24 volts, I put in this 5-conductor Wago right there because I had four wires. I had power, and I had one line or one yellow from a couple of the other zone valves that are all together, and the other one is a 2, which is right here. All right, I'm gonna put all these back in there, nice and neat. Right, I'm gonna put that plate back on, and then we're gonna put the new cover on. We're gonna label that master, or we'll name it 207 master. This is due north. We have our 4-car. Garage door, north side, boom. There it is. There's the outdoor air sensor. All right, let me go up there and see what's going on. Damn, I'm effing good, bro.
What happened?
This is it. A good technician is observant of his surroundings. I love what I do, by the way. What does that say?
Outdoor temperature sensor.
POS. All right, we're going to use this, and we'll have an outdoor air sensor.
All right. There it is. Right there. Let's go see if the error is gone off the boiler.
By the way, 1978. I'm 1 year older than that beast. Oh, beautiful Porsche 911. Look at that. Beautiful. All right, always uncut, unedited, raw. And it's gone. Beautiful. Beautiful. Love Buderus, owned by Bosch. Let's go, Bosch.
That guy is genuinely a really nice guy.
He is.
All right, it's like, you get these, some, you know, people who have all this wealth, and it really gets right to their head, but I think he earned it. It was all himself, you know? Made it himself, and sitting on 5 acres of land, it's crazy. Beautiful house, beautiful.
It's a castle, it's not even a house.
It's not a house, it's like a castle. Sorry, I don't want to show, I don't want to reveal too much of it. You've already seen his boiler room. But a genuinely nice guy. But an easy service call. We're there for a little over an hour. We're charging for an hour. Right? And what prompted us here wasn't too much about the radiant in the master bathroom not working. He was worried about that, the OA error on the boiler. Mm-hmm. And that was the outdoor air sensor error. And again, a good technician is observant of his surroundings. You know, if you look at the quality, look at that house, by the way. By the way, the walls match the house. It's like you're like Versailles. But listen, that house, that whole house was engineered. All the mechanical systems in the house were engineered. And you best believe that outdoor air sensor was going on a north exposure wall. Because there's no sun on the north side, right?
It's true, yeah.
And we thought logically, listen, okay, outside, right outside the boiler room outside, we have some northern exposure there, a little bit. Mm-hmm. But let's think more outside the box. Northern Boulevard is that way, your garage faces that way, and let's go look outside by the garage. And sure enough, you look up behind, and right there it was, all corroded because the cover fell off and it was all broken up. We threw in the Navian one, working perfectly like a champ. All right, be well, God bless, stay safe.